Earlier today, I was at the U.S. Capitol where I had a chance to speak with Senator Katie Britt of Alabama about the border crisis and what she hopes can be done to resolve it. This comes as President Biden signs an executive order on immigration policy and Republican senators renewing their calls to pass the Laken and Riley Act. Senator Katie Britt, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Of course, Senator. You sponsored the Laken and Riley Act. This passed through the companion bill with bipartisan support, mind you, in the House of Representatives, yet it's being blocked in the Senate. What gives?
Yeah, so I really appreciate, obviously, Mike Collins' leadership there in the House. To your point, it got through in a bipartisan nature with over 30 Democrats stepping up to the plate and saying, we want to be a part of being a solution. Unfortunately, what we see in the Senate is just more of the same. It's Chuck Schumer playing games. It's antics. It's politics instead of actual process that leads to securing our border and making America safer. So I'm proud to co-sponsor this, obviously, lead it with Senator Ted Budd. We have over, there are 47 of us that are co-sponsors of this piece of legislation. Yet Chuck Schumer, instead of putting our bill on the floor, chose to put a bill that only received 43 votes total. So it shows you kind of what we're up against. They don't want real solutions. They just want something they can go out and talk about and create a partisan divide. And so we're going to keep fighting. We actually put it on the floor last week. Senator Lindsey Graham and I went to the floor to try to get it voted on and voted on unanimously. And unfortunately, Democrats blocked it. Senator Dick Durbin said no. And we've even followed up with him. Steve, we've said, hey, let's do a hearing. Let's let the American people hear the evidence, hear what the bill does, and let's put it in front of the people. And we believe if we're able to do that, ultimately, we'll win.
Senator, we saw yesterday two New York City police officers, one of them shot, the other one shot at, by an illegal Venezuelan immigrant. How important is this legislation to prevent future violent crime?
Oh, it's huge. It's huge. So, I mean, just take a look. So this piece of legislation says two things. It says, one, if an illegal alien commits theft or burglary, they have to be detained and deported. Now, if that had happened with Laken Riley's alleged murderer, he wouldn't have been here to take her life. She would still be alive today. And so we know that there is nothing we can do to bring Laken back. But what we need to do is to be able to prevent this from happening in the future. And this piece of legislation does just that. And then it also allows states' attorneys general to actually bring an injunction against the Biden administration for not actually enforcing the law. So we continue to see the Department of Homeland Security skirt things like asylum and parole, amongst other things, not doing what they need to on detaining and deporting these illegal aliens. And so this piece of legislation would say that they can actually bring suit against the Department of Homeland Security and these liberal bureaucrats that have an agenda, which is not that of us securing our homeland. So we're seeing this happen all across the country. Senator Ernst has a great bill, Sarah's Law, that has some similar components to it when it comes to these illegal aliens that are committing crimes. We have to stand up. We have to be unafraid to stand for Americans. We know we're a nation of immigrants, but we are a nation of laws. But this administration continuously chooses not to enforce the law. And then they also weaponize the arms of justice, so to speak, to come against people who don't agree with them. And it's disgusting, it's despicable, and we're going to keep speaking up loud, strongly, and directly on behalf of the American people.
Senator, lastly, this isn't just a border state and blue state issue by default because of soft on crime policy, but in your state of Alabama, your home state, how are your constituents being directly affected by this border crisis?
Oh, gosh. Every state is a border state. Every community across Alabama is being affected by Joe Biden's open border policies. I mean, first off, you look at the over 10 million people that have come here under Joe Biden's watch. He has consistently told us he has zero tools to deal with this when we knew that wasn't true. He actually created this crisis. He inherited the most secure border of all time. President Trump had created the most secure border. He came in and what he did, Joe Biden did, was he did 94 executive orders in the first 100 days. He immediately said, I am going to halt construction of the border wall. We're going to stop deportations, and I'm going to give amnesty to millions of people who are here illegally. What that did, those things acted as a magnet to draw more and more and more people there. And now that is affecting every community across the country and in Alabama. When you look at the safety and security of our streets, let's think about this. You had the FBI director a few months ago say that there were blinking lights everywhere. When you look at the 1.8 million people and growing that we have no idea who they are, these are known gotaways, so people we absolutely never touch gloves with. So we don't know who they are, where they're going, or what their intentions are. They are here in the United States, in every community, and it's just completely and totally unacceptable that this administration prioritizes their quote-unquote right to be here, which they do not have, over the safety and security of people all across America. And then look at fentanyl. Okay, so fentanyl, leading cause of death between the ages of 18 and 45 in this nation. We know where this is coming from. The precursors come from China. They make their way to Mexico. They go across our border, and they are literally killing upwards of 300 people a day.
Senator Katie Britt, thank you so much.
Thank you.